I was at a local Target department store yesterday, and a young woman that looked like she was about 11 months pregnant was holding the hand of a toddler and walking towards me as I was placing the items I had just purchased into the car. When she started asking me if I had any spare change, I asked her a couple of questions that were way more valuable than any quarters, nickels, dimes, or singles I had left from my exchange, like, where is the father of her child? And are you sure that you're ready to bring another baby into the world under these circumstances that you're currently facing? She then curled up her nose, got indignant, and began talking about Jesus and telling me that I shouldn't judge. So I told her, fine, since I can't judge or share my opinion, I won't be donating any money. This woman then starts cussing me out and calling me all sorts of names. So I told the young woman to have a good day. I got in the car, and as she started walking with her young child to the front of the department store to beg more customers for spare change, I made an anonymous phone call to the police and Child Protective Services. I then waited in the parking lot until they arrived. When they got there, I went ahead and flagged the officers down in the parking lot and directed them to the entrance of the store where this pregnant woman and her underage child were. Once the officers confronted the woman, she immediately broke down crying, talking about, it's hard out here for a single mom trying to make it. So these simps with badges started telling her that they understood her plight and that things would get better. Then one of the officers looks towards me with a frown and asked me why I called the police and CPS on the woman. And I told him that she's endangering the life of a minor and breaking social ordinance and code violations under the statute of the state of Maryland and Prince George's County, Maryland. So the officer then tells me, hey man, cut it out. Can't you see the lady's having a hard time? So I said to this officer, you guys should be thanking me because I'm doing preventative maintenance for the community because it's women like this who know that they don't have the means to support and properly nurture a child who spread their legs for anyone who passes time and smiles at them once or twice. By law, they're granted the right to do whatever they decide to do with their bodies, even though the choices they make cause serious harm to other people, far worse than the damage that any secondhand cigarette smoke that lingers behind does to a non-smoker who inhales those cancerous carbon monoxide fumes. These women keep choosing to become single mothers. Then the same women turn right around and place these same children that they knew they couldn't afford on the shoulders of John Q. and Jane Doe public taxpayer. And it's far more than an economic burden that John and Jane Doe must take on. Aside from paying higher taxes and insurance premiums that are through the roof, John and Jane Doe's life are at risk when these women's children get a bit older and start resorting to car theft, burglary, and other forms of criminal activity as a way of acting out due to the lack of stability that they have in their home, or to make ends meet themselves. Every day I see my mother struggling. Now it's time, I've got to do something. I look for work, I get dissed like a jerk. I do odd jobs and come home like a slob. So here comes Rob, his goal is shimmery. He gives me 200 for a quick delivery. I do it once, I do it twice. I told the officer straight up that my issue was not the fact that I didn't want to be bothered over the change I had left after leaving the department store. I care less about that. My issue was the fact that that pregnant single mom who was begging for change with a knee-high toddler beneath her swollen belly was unfit to be a mother. And just like any person who is operating a motor vehicle with a disability that hinders their performance, or they're driving impaired because of drug or alcohol consumption, this mother should have all parental rights stripped from her at once. And when I said this, the officer couldn't say a word because he knew I was right. But once I was done saying what I said, some slew-footed, sweet tea guzzling, party wing nibbling sister who was eavesdropping jumped into the conversation, talking about, wait a goddamn minute, she didn't do this by herself. And I said, yes, she did. She chose this road on her own. I told Miss Busybody that women like herself are at fault because their denial has transformed single motherhood into something that not only became acceptable, but fashionable. Right after I said that, the cop told me that I was free to go because he didn't want the debate to escalate into a public fiasco. So I left my personal information just in case CPS needed a witness statement or there was any future public disturbance in general from this pregnant panhandler. So all you people out there with common sense who are tired of ratchetness consuming everything around you, as tough as it may seem, this is what we must do if we wish to change things for the better. Don't wait until these women's children become thugs and gangbanging trash or another litter-producing hood rat with a new generation of vermin that does nothing but destroy the environment like some bioengineered plague. Nip it in the bud right away. We gotta be like that old Alice Cooper song from back in the day. No more Mr. Nice Guy, no more Mr. Clean. Take motherhood away from these women who don't deserve to be mothers. That is all I have to say on this matter. Comment, rate, and subscribe.